Hello YouTube, it's Accurate again. First of all, I want to thank everybody for supporting this channel and for watching my videos and commenting and stuff. This video is going to be quite similar to my most popular one on the channel, where I sampled a piece of vinyl and make a beat out of it in the OP-1 standalone. The record I'm using today is this one. Mahalia Jackson, I believe. And this one was originally released in 55, so I sat down the other day and I found a sample on here that I think I'm going to be able to sample. I haven't tried it yet, but I think it's going to be possible. I guess I'm going to give it a try. Right, let's go to the drum sampler arm. Let's sample. All right, I want to be sure that I get everything from this, so I'm going to keep on recording on another slot. The sample is in here. Now I'm just gonna try to chop it up. I think I found a bunch of sounds here that are going to be usable, but I'm still going to check into the other sample I took from the same track. Alright, enough with the sample editing. As always, I actually figured out a way to play the samples while chopping them, so I guess it's about time to record it on tape. 94 BPMs, and the tape is empty, so 1, 2, 3, 4 bars, set a loop right there, and it goes a little something like that sounds alright, but I think I find it a bit boring, so maybe I'll try to pitch it up. I think it's a bit dry, so I'm gonna add a reverb to it. So let's just give it another go on the tape. I don't know why, but I just like that more. So the next step is to add some drums to the sequence. I'm gonna take this record off the platter and I'm gonna sample this one. The amazing Rhythm Aces, Burning the Ballroom Down. This is a traditional rock album from 78, released on ABC Records. So let's sample the drums to the OP-1. I'm gonna go right in and slice them up. Happy at all with that, so it's something that's missing here. I think I'm gonna have to change the tempo of the track, or maybe the pitch of the sample, or maybe sample some other drum sounds, because I can't get this to sound as hard or energetic as I want it to be. So I'm actually trying to increase the tempo and lower the pitch of the sample, just one semitone, see if that makes a difference. Well, I still don't like the sound of that, so instead of using the drums from the amazing Rhythm Aces album, I'm gonna use one of my own old kits. I know I've used them in another video, but I'm also gonna use one of my favorite features in the OP-1. I can just record anything on the fly and just hit the out button, and that marks the end of the loop. And that way I don't have to care about the metronome and the tempo of the track at all. That's gonna cause me some problems if I'm transferring this into Logic, but whatever. Let's just go to record mode on the second track. Like that, and on the first track. So actually this is a lot closer to what I was aiming for than all the first tries. Sometimes it takes time, sometimes it doesn't. But I also want to shoehorn something out of these drums. Oh, that snare could be added in there. But I'm gonna do it on track 3, I think, because I'm a coward. Well, it doesn't sync perfectly with the first snare on every hit, but I think that adds a bit of human feel to it also. I'm happy with that. So next up on track 4, I'm gonna put a bass line, and I'm using one of the built-in synth engines in the OP-1. This one is called Dr. Wave. Well, I'm pretty happy with the first 4 bars of this beat, but it's gonna be too repetitive to use just like that. So I copied the drums and the bass line over here, so I have 4 more bars, and I'm gonna do something else with the sample. That's about it. Now I'm just gonna record it into the computer and make a longer track and make some adjustments with the filter knobs and the stuff like that. Maybe put some scratch on it. So thanks for watching. I go by the name of Accurate. Right here.
right, that's right.